Welcome to today's class. Our lecture for today is the sensory pathway system. And we would be limiting this lecture to the upper head region and the face. This is our learning objectives. And I hope that going through this lecture, we should be able to describe the sensory pathway for touch and pressure, the sensory pathway for proprioception and jaw jack, the sensory pathway for pain and temperature. And lastly, we should be able to describe the sensory cortex, where this interpretation is sensed or perceived. So the sensory pathway basically entails chains of neurons that are connected one after the other. They connect from the target site, which in this regard would be the face. Neurons around this region are connected in a chain network and they run upward to the cerebrum hemisphere where the sensation is perceived. The functions of the sensory pathway. The sensory pathway are responsible for the transmission of sensory stimuli such as touch, pressure, proprioception, pain or temperature. We have different kinds of sensation that we can feel within the face. You can feel the sense of touch when someone touches the face. When there is pressure applied, we can feel that this is like a push. Then proprioception is the sensation of body movement. This occurs basically in the lower jaw. When you talk, you can feel the sense that your jaws are moving. You can sense that this part is actually being moved. Also, pain. When you have pain in an area around the face, you can also feel the sensation. Or temperature, when you feel hotness around the face region. All these type of sensory stimuli are felt around the face and they are interpreted in the cerebral cortex. The entire body, for the sake of the sensory pathway, will be divided into the upper head region and also the face region. The sensory innervation of this region is carried by the trigeminal nerve. So the trigeminal nerve are actually responsible for carrying sensory stimuli around the face region. And for the posterior part of the head, then downwards, the remaining part of the body, these are carried by spinal nerves. So we have in the cervical region, we have the cervical nerve, the thoracic, the lumbar, the sacral, like that. The anterior upper head region and the face region is the focus for this lecture. And we've described in our initial slide that the sensory stimuli from this region is carried by the trigeminal nerve. The trigeminal nerve is the fifth cranial nerve. It is the most complex nerve. It is also the biggest. It is further subdivided into three branches. We have the ophthalmic branch, which is the first division. This is a sole sensory nerve. What it does is to carry just sensory stimuli. You see it at the upper part. This is the first branch of the trigeminal nerve. The second branch of the trigeminal nerve is the maxillary nerve. This maxillary nerve is also solely for sensory innervation. So this is the mandibular branch division, and this is the third branch of the trigeminal nerve. It is made up of both motor and sensory components. And this is where it is. It is the most distal branch. So we can say all in all that the bulk of the trigeminal nerve is made up of sensory components. So let's quickly look at the trigeminal nerve. We said that the trigeminal nerve is the fifth cranial nerve. It emerges from three nuclei, and that is why it is the biggest cranial nerve. It emerges from three nuclei, from the midbrain to the pons to the medulla. It has a very large root. They unite around the level of the pons in the trigeminal ganglion. The root from the three nuclei, that is from the midbrain, the pons, and the medulla, unites in the ganglion. This ganglion is a collection of the sensory root from the three nuclei. So from this region, they are still located within the cranial fossa. They need to find a way through which they will exit the cranium to supply regions around the face. So the trigeminal ganglion is made up of pseudo-unipolar neurons, which means that they have a false presentation looking as if they are unipolar. Meanwhile, they have two extensions from the body. After the formation of the ganglion, the trigeminal nerve tends to divide into three divisions, which are the ophthalmic, the maxillary, and also the mandibular branch. These three branches need to find their way out of the cranial cavity so that they can innervate structures around the upper head and the face region. So the ophthalmic nerve, which is the first branch of the trigeminal nerve, finds its way out of the cranial cavity through the superior orbital feature. This is where it passes through to exit the neurocranium so as to supply regions around the upper scalp, the forehead region, and the high region. The maxillary branch is the second branch, and of course, it leaves the neurocranium through the foramen rotundo to enter into the mid third of the face. Then we have the last branch, which is the mandibular branch, that enters through the foramen ovale to supply the lower part of the face or around the lower jaw. So that is how they exit the skull, through different foramen. So I've tried to carve out a mnemonic, so FRO, which means the superior orbital feature through which the ophthalmic nerve passes through to supply the upper part of the face. Then we have the R, which means the foramen rotundo, through which the maxillary branch of the trigeminal nerve exits the neurocranium. And we have the foramen ovale, through which the mandibular branch of the trigeminal nerve exits the neurocranium to supply the lower part of the face. So the trigeminal pathway system, how do we feel this sensation? How do we feel the sense of touch? How do we feel the sense of pressure? You apply pressure on the face. How do you feel that sense that something is pressing on my face? The sense of pain, the sense of temperature. How do you feel that there's possibly an increase in temperature? What are the pathways involved in this sensation? This is going to be a very interesting pathway. So let's follow suit to enjoy this. Well, I've tried to classify the pathway into three based on the types of sensory stimuli that is being generated and sensed. So I've tried to classify them into three. We have the mesencephalic trigeminal pathway, we have the main sensory trigeminal pathway, and we have the spinal trigeminal pathway. The mesencephalic trigeminal pathway basically is responsible for the sensation of proprioception and jaw jack. You can feel the movement or also the position around your face. The main sensory pathway carries basically touch and also pressure. You can touch your face and feel it. You can apply pressure. This is strictly what they carry. Then the spinal trigeminal pathway carry pain. Maybe you have your cheek pained, or you have a sharp object striking the surface of your face, you can feel those kind of pain sensation through the spinal trigeminal pathway. So let's take those pathways one after the other. So we'll take a look at the mesencephalic trigeminal pathway. We've said that this pathway, what they carry basically is proprioception and also jaw jack. You can feel the change in position, also movement of regions around the face. So this is what the mesencephalic trigeminal pathway carry. This is where the sensory roots unite in the ganglion. So from the ganglion, we have a neuron running through, whether it's from the upper face, the mid face, or the lower face, they receive or pick that sensation, which must be either proprioception or a jaw jack kind of stimuli. It runs through the trigeminal ganglion. This is the trigeminal ganglion. It runs through, it goes to the mesencephalic sensory nucleus. Remember when we talk about the nucleus of the trigeminal nerve, we say they have nucleus rooted within the midbrain, the pons, and the medulla. In the midbrain, the name of the nucleus is the mesencephalic nucleus. In the pons, they have the main or the principal nucleus. In the medulla, they have the spinal nucleus. So for proprioception, the neurons enter into the mesencephalic sensory nucleus. When they enter into the mesencephalic sensory nucleus, the second neuron picks it up from there, but it now decrusates and ascends. So it's run in the opposite side and ascends upward to enter into the thalamus. The thalamus is a region of the brain that is located between the cerebrum hemisphere and the midbrain. So they are like located between the two structures. And thalamus basically are known as relay station. What they do are just points where there are connections. They create connection points for neurons to move through. So they are like relay station. And where it enters into is in the ventral posterior medial nucleus of the thalamus. When it gets there, another neuron, which is the third set of neurons, will pick it from the thalamus and take it to the cerebrum hemisphere, specifically on the sensory cortex, where the sensation will be felt. You can now feel the sense of change in position or movement. Then the second grade of movement is the main sensory trigeminal pathway. And what this carries is touch and also pressure. And it's also run in the same path with the mesencephalic trigeminal pathway, but just a change in the nucleus where they are intercepted. We have neurons which could come from the V1 region, the V2, or the V3 region, but what they carry is just touch and pressure. So they carry and they move through the trigeminal ganglion, and they now run into the chief, the principal, or the main sensory nucleus. So this is where they are located in the pons, and this is where they enter into. And another neuron synapse and carry it from there to enter into the thalamus, just as the mesencephalic trigeminal pathway. The specific region of the thalamus where it relay into is the ventral posterior medial nucleus in the thalamus. And from there, the third set of neurons will also pick it up and take it to the cerebral cortex, just as the first pathway. But the only difference is that while this synapse in the mesencephalic nucleus, which is located in the midbrain region, this synapse in the main or chief sensory nucleus, which is located in the pons. And the third trigeminal pathway is the spinal trigeminal pathway. This is specifically for pain and temperature. So it also runs like the first two, but the only difference is that the nucleus where the synapse is the spinal nucleus, which is located in the medulla. So we have the first set of neurons running through regions from V1, V2, V3. They enter into the trigeminal ganglion. And in this case, they descend downwards, and they need to descend for them to form synapse in the spinal nucleus, because the spinal nucleus is actually located in the medulla oblongata. Then another set of neurons picks it up from here, and they enter into the ventral posterior medial nucleus in the thalamus. From the thalamus, another set of neurons then take this up to the cerebrum hemisphere. If you look at this region, the second grade of neurons collect it and they run upward, forming like a tract around this point. So this tract is called the trigeminal lemniscus. This trigeminal lemniscus is like a collection of axons formed by the second grade of neurons that runs from the nuclei of the trigeminal nerve to the thalamus. The sensory cortex is the region where the sensory stimuli are perceived. We know that the entire cerebrum hemisphere is divided into an outer layer and an inner layer. The inner layer is whitish in color, which is called the white matter, while the outer layer is grayish in color, which is called the gray matter. The outer covering, which is also referred to as the cerebral cortex, is responsible for neural integration. And what you see on the cerebral cortex on the outside are involutions. You see sulci and gyri. It's not smooth. You see elevation and depression. Where you have elevation is called the gyri. Where you have the depression is called the sulci. So if you look at this, there's a very big sulcus that divides the frontal lobe from the parietal lobe, and this is called the central sulcus. This central sulcus, we have an elevation behind it, and we have an elevation in front. The elevation anterior to it is called the motor cortex. while the elevation, which is the gyrus that is located behind the central sulcus, is called the sensory cortex. So it is this region that the innervation from the three trigeminal pathway finally are related to. You could also say that this is the postcentral gyrus. It is the postcentral gyrus because it is the gyrus that is located behind the central sulcus. This is the precentral gyrus because it is the gyrus that is located anterior to the central sulcus. So this is postcentral gyrus. So this is a task for us. And this says that we should describe the trigeminal sensory innervation of the face using an illustrative diagram. We should also highlight different sensations that run in the three nuclei of the trigeminal nerve. We've said that the trigeminal nerve has three nuclei extending from the midbrain down to the medulla. So the different nuclei are responsible for specific type of sensation. Write a short note on the sensory cortex. Where is it located and what does it do? So thanks for watching. I'll be expecting questions in the comment section. Let's meet in our next class.